No prescriptions filled, no medicines being mixed. A notice on the front door of the Sangre Grande Hospital dispensary informs patients it's closed for the day. The safety concern inside, barrels of medical-grade alcohol in close proximity to large generators. Pharmacists who were not allowed to speak on camera told TV6 management is defying orders from the fire department and storing the flammable liquid close to heat sources. Across in radiology, workers estimated 40 to 50 outpatients were turned away today because of the industrial action. The workers recently met refuse crowding the walkway to the staff entrance of the employees' lounge. Flies swarming around the garbage make their way inside the lounge, too. This has been the scene at the Sangre Grande Hospital for the last week. Workers from across a multitude of departments, radiology, medical records, administration, the dispensary, all on a go slow, some going so far as to essentially shut down their departments because they're protesting their conditions of work. They say they're just too deplorable for them to continue. But there's more in the mortar here. These are some long-standing occupational health and safety issues that they have, but what has escalated the frustration and the tension is what they say is the attitude and personality of their CEO, Amina Ali. Staff members couldn't speak on camera, but they complained that the CEO is verbally abrasive to staff and has arbitrarily threatened to fire at least two of them. They gave TV6 a copy of a circular which instructs heads of departments to record which workers are engaging in protest action, a move the workers claim is intimidatory. Ms. Ali contends the workers' protest is partly a backlash to initiatives that improve efficiency. She says she's reined in overtime and put managers on a shift system so they're on site day and night.
They see that not as a management for better service in public. They see it as they come to use the exact word, come to spy.
She's resisting calls for her to go, saying her performance is efficient and effective, and any move to pressure her out would set a dangerous precedent.
After I go under this pressure that they feel that, that they protest him, right? What happens to the other managers? The next day they will come and say, matron must go?
As for the flammable liquids near the dispensary, Ms. Ali says an unsuccessful attempt had been made to relocate the barrels. But they were placed in an open area and exposed to cigarettes, which she says was a potentially more dangerous scenario. She says the hospital's patients and the Sangre Grande community are the ones being affected by the workers' action, especially the 6 or 7 chemotherapy patients who depend on the hospital for treatment. Fain Richards, TV6 News.